Astrology is the basic science that deals with. The study of the fundamentals of everything. So there are two concepts in ontological study. It is of onto-anthropology and onto-sociology that deals with the fundamentals of human behavior. Just as in pathology, the fundamental root of a disease is identified, and the nature of disease at its fundamental itself, if it is identified, then an effective uprooting process of the disease so that it will not be repatriated again can be inferred. Likewise, all human beings, their greater qualities as well as their inherent inferior qualities, their fundamental studies are organized in this system. When human beings, they evolved, they had advanced instincts because of their extra space performance of their cerebral mechanism in the form of uploading more consciousness message and manifestation. The brain system or the neuro-intellectual system of human beings, they have a broader space, they have a broader receptivity by means of having more management of consciousness and manifestation of consciousness, apart from all the other living beings. So there are two types of instincts which we have to study. Without instinctive study, that's what we used to say, machines are neutral. No machines have been invented by themselves. No machines are operated by themselves. Any social system, political system, technical system, they are identified by human beings, they are operated by human beings. Whether they are practiced or malpracticed, they are done by human beings. Whether the people are benefited or victimized, they are also human beings. So everything is a human mind. And unless the impact of mind and regularization of mind is not dealt in an individual way, in a collective way, in a social way, in a national way, in a global way, the study of all the other systems, they will be useless. And number one, the impact level is also to be studied. The impact of human mind, depending upon the value of the person. The impact of a small person, for example, if the impact of a person who is just an individual, who is unconnected with the society, if the person is angry, if the person is depressed, then it may affect him or his family. The same person is having the addictive powers of sentimental violence, the same person wherein by his depression that host malice, which is also fueled by an extra power which is known as sentimental violence, that the same person will be the destroyer, he will be a predator of the society. So unless these things are curbed, unless these things are classified, categorized and captivated at the budding level itself, we cannot do anything. That's why we have to make an instinctive study of all of these things, because defense mechanism or defense electronics, security mechanism, everything came from instincts. There is a basic defense instinct that is embedded in each and every biological matter. Each and every biological matter that has three primary instincts. One is the instinct to identify, to nurture and to imbibe the mechanisms that make the organism to flourish. It is known as acceptive mechanism, or it is known as an inhibitive mechanism, in which all the other essentials in the form of food, in the form of oxygen, in the form of water, in the form of its own clan. So identity of any other thing that is biological or biosource in nature that paves the way for the survival and flourishing of an organism, that is felt in the first instinct. That is known as food instinct, that is known as a relativity or mating instinct, or that is known as socialization instinct. The second thing is defense instinct. As everybody, how it came, defense instinct is not a separate instinct. Everybody who is having the instinct to attack, they will have a counterpart which is known as defense. And defense is not a very great instinct. Defense and attack are common, and these type of instincts, they are glorified or they are petrified or nullified or blamed depending upon the area or the circumstance where it is upheld. If the defensive mechanism is applied towards the innocent unconnectedly for violent reason, then the same defense mechanism, that becomes something notorious. If the same thing attack, if it is towards other people, that becomes notorious. So depending upon the persons or the purpose where it is being applied, it is defined as either terrorism or patriotism. Terrorism and patriotism, they have the common base. Substantial base is very common. But the thing that is different is their application area. Whereas each and everybody has the instinct to attack others. because of three things. One is uncertainty, because human beings, they are having a very basic instinct. That basic instinct is not knowing anything. It may be ignorance. If something is not revealed, that is known as ignorance. If something is not manifested in the person, that is known as innocence. If something is not revealed, that is ignorance. If the same thing that has been revealed in the society, which has not been revealed or manifested in some people, that is known as innocent. We cannot say that somebody to be innocent and somebody to be ignorant in different terms. So, we can say somebody innocent because of their non-affinity with the so-called social maturity. But ignorance is non-availability. If a person is, for example, in a rural area, that is ignorance because he is not connected with the urbanization benefits. If there is a child, because of lack of manifestation of understanding the ethos and the ethnical as well as the ethical backgrounds, that is known as innocence. So all of these mechanisms of uncertainty is there, not knowing things because of insufficiency, because of misapprehension, because of malpractice, because of negligence, because of oblivion, because of nescience in the form of ignorance and innocence, people, they are not knowing things. So if something is not known, it is fear of the unknown. And you must know something, as human being, he has the tendency to attack. Any organism, it has the tendency to attack. It mistakes every moment of any organism that it is going to attack. This has resulted in the form of defense. So, defense mechanism is of two reasons or of two divisions. The first defense mechanism is, as a person, a human being or any organism, it has the tools and instinct to attack. Attack is for two things. It is also out of the fear of the unknown. It also poses, it is juxtaposition of one's own inherence and other things, or it is known as a common assumption or a common presumption or attributive perception, adhyaropita bhava in Sanskrit or attributive perception in English, in psychology. If you are, for example, if I am a thief, then wherever I see a person with blinking eyes, I'll think that already normal people with blinking eyes, if somebody is seen, immediately they'll think them as a thief. If the person is also a thief, suddenly he will conclude everybody as a thief. Like that, it is known as attributive.